Bam.
Are you videotaping this?
This is for YouTube. I have a channel on YouTube.
Yeah?
Yeah. So, what'd you have to run home for?
I sold some bug beds.
Oh, cool.
So we bid on some auction stuff.
Uh-huh.
And,
I saw nothing.
We ended up buying, my wife bought a room. Local bug beds.
Uh-huh.
Two rooms. One for 25 cents, one for 75 cents. Didn't know how many beds were in there. So 16 bug beds.
So, was this like a storage shed?
No, it was a campground.
Oh!
It's a camp, but it was like a retreat center.
Okay.
So they were closing down, so they're auctioning everything off.
I see.
Yeah, so I bid on a few things I wanted for the shop here. So I said, well, I'm going, so you should bid on some stuff. So she did. So when I was tearing them apart, I said, well, I'm not going to do these, so I listed them on Facebook.
Uh-huh.
$20 a piece. And she had them all sold by the time I got them all loaded up.
Oh. So we're gonna do a highball fade with hard part, and then if you could raise or shave the sides, that'd be awesome. Please.
Highball fade, like how high?
I'm gonna leave that to your discretion.
Okay. And then you part it this way?
Yep.
So you might as well just set up camp there.
Oh, it sounds like a hotel or what? Well, you could call it a hotel, I guess, but it's more of a very old motel.
Just
renting
my RV.
Trust me, if my truck was running and my camper was running, my horse trailer, yeah. I go find a campground, pull that thing in, and that's where I stay. Only reason I stay where I do is because in that way the company picks it up.
Yeah.
Yep. So besides selling bunk beds, what else is new?
Well, business is crazy.
Isn't that a good thing?
Well, it is. It's almost a little bit busy. I'm gonna have to be probably hiring some sooner than I thought.
Yeah.
Which isn't necessarily a bad thing, but you know, you've got to find the right person.
Oh, yeah. So, how many people do you have that come in on Thursday nights, your late night, right?
Yeah. It just depends, like, last week was Thanksgiving, but I was booked this Thursday. So, I was booked all last week, and I was booked today, and then I took probably 4 appointments tomorrow.
Oh, wow.
So,
well, Scott, you might have to start opening back open on a Saturday, buddy.
Well, yeah, but I hear you.
I mean, if you're that busy that, you know, you got so many people that are still wanting.
Yeah, and mainly because it's the holidays, I believe. You know, if it wasn't the holidays, I don't know if I'd be this as busy.
Uh-huh.
So that's why I'm doing a little extra too. So, but like yesterday I had 4 people try try to walk in. So
I'm sure they were disappointed when you're like, yeah, I'm only appointment only.
No, I think people understood, but it takes a while to train people.
Oh yeah. Well, that's why right now working over on the west side of the state and coming through Des Moines, it's just easier. Hey, I just texted you just to see if you were busy tonight.
Yeah.
Because since last time I was up here, you said, hey, if you ever come through on a Friday, let me know. And
yeah, that way you don't have to make a trip back.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I mean, right now, it's busy, but I know you're someone who is in the morning.
Oh,
so that was crazy. So I sold all them beds, and I'll probably get the other ones. So able to pay for all the other auction stuff that I got.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm gonna bought these mailboxes, like they're a post office box. So 25 of them.
Why?
Because I'm gonna have, because old barbershops, remember the old barbershops that had mugs? Like a mug.
Oh, like a mug. Oh, yeah.
So I'm gonna have one. I think I'm gonna put them right in here. And then I'm actually going to probably have like a club thing. Like it'll be a certain amount and it'll be a club, and I don't exactly know the details, but like you might get a shirt, you might get a mug, whatever it might be.
Okay.
Like, it might be haircuts, whatever you put in there, you know. It might be like a subscription thing.
I see.
So it'll be 25 spots. Yeah, so that's why I originally wanted it. And then I bid on a bunch of other stuff. So it's really cool. Take these there's a tripod, but it's thing.
Oh, okay.
And it's meant to, it's like a stabilizing thing. So it's got a gyroscope on it. When you hold it, you can move the thing around. The camera stays stable.
Nice.
And then look it up, and it goes to $300 to $600. And I got this thing for a whole lot for $50. Tambourines. No, Mr. Tambourine.
All right, what have you done with Real Scott Sales that I met like a couple years ago?
This is nothing, man.
This is not the same barber I met.
Right.
I don't know. This just does not seem like you, Scott.
Right.
5 tambourines, 16 bunk beds, and...
Well, I sold all the bunk beds.
Well, I
that
know.
Was the bonus. My that... wife wanted the desk out of there. And I didn't know there was 16 bunk beds. So, get this. I loaded all the woods, like plywood, particle board for every bed. So, 32 beds. I loaded all that in my truck.
Hmm.
Not nice.
Nice. That's what a truck's for.
I know, but
That is what a truck is for.
I had the whole thing loaded and the mud flaps were about 2 inches off the ground.
Oh, you had her squatting.
Oh yeah.
You had her squatting.
I drove all the way back.
That's a good job.
I was gonna try to get all the beds, but I'm like, okay, I don't think I can load anymore.
Oh, half ton?
I don't know, Ford F-150?
Yep, that's a half ton.
Alright.
So Ford is...
I was like this.
But Ford is F-150, F-250, F-350. So that's half ton, three quarter tonner. GMC and Chevy is 1500, 2500, 3500. Ram is the same way. So.
Yeah. So it was crazy. Because I'm driving down the road, like, you know, normally that's when you're driving the road and you can, like, reach for something.
Uh-huh.
I couldn't do that. Any little slight movement of the tire, and the thing starts going like this.
Don't you know how to steer and drive and then reach one hand for what you need?
When I'm lat loaded, no.
Oh, buddy boy. Oh.
I don't think there's much weight on the front. Like, I was loaded.
Well, trust me, I was working in Cedar Rapids at Menards during college, and this one lady came in and with a truck, came into the drywall shed and wanted a pallet of 4x4 sheets of plywood, of drywall that we had cut down. And she wanted me to set it in the back of her truck. Okay, well, I picked the pallet up, and of course that's with the forklift, and I went to go towards her truck, and she's like, well, don't. I set it down, and she's like, well, can you scoot it in a little bit more? I said, yeah. And I went to pick it up, and she said, well, don't scratch it, it's my baby's. I'm thinking in the back of my head, lady, it's a truck. The beds are supposed to be a little bit scratched, because they work. And I looked at her, and I said, ma'am, I said, I have to be able to pick up and slide along the bed of your truck so that I can get it scooted in. I said, I won't hurt your truck, but for me to do it, I have to pick up and kind of angle it to push. Oh, but I was just like, really? It's your baby?
Of course.
It's a truck.
I saw somebody that spray bed lined their whole truck.
Oh yeah?
Which I heard when I did my camper, and I did the roof of my camper.
Uh-huh.
I heard about that too. I thought that was a pretty good idea. I'd like to do it to the sidewalls of my truck, wheel wells.
There's a lot of people that, when they spray the bed of the truck, they do it all. They don't just do the main bed of the truck.
Yeah.
They do the whole thing of the truck. Frozen, and then it gets warm, and then by sometime in the afternoon, you know, it gets a little bit warmer, but then it begins to go back down. So I normally work 7:30 to 5, and on Fridays then we get to, us guys that live far enough away, we get to leave a little bit early. And like tonight, we just got out of there before 4 o'clock, so I only got off basically about an hour early. Which is not real fun, because then a 3.5 hour drive took me home at 7:30, 8 o'clock.
I normally get back like 11.
Every Friday. I live down in Blakesburg. So from Blakesburg to my job site and back It's 3.5 hours.
Yeah, but I thought you got off later.
Only during the summertime. Only during the summertime. Ooh, that feels good. So when we pick out bridges, depending on what they are made of, like one we got done with in a town called Malvern, it was a wooden bridge we took out that was like 100 years old, and we put a concrete one in its place. This one that we're taking out is an old concrete bridge, and to get it out, there's a big jackhammer, basically, that goes on the front of our excavator, and it breaks it all apart, and when you break all the concrete out, then it grabs a hold of all the rebar, and whatever concrete didn't break loose from the rebar, we cut it off. Otherwise, we'll build a work bridge, and then that'll go below in the creek so that a crane can get down there. That way we can swing out over top of the bridge when we need to. And
what's up, Mark? Huh?
Not at the house anymore?
No.
I just getting off work and I seen like
Scott. Yeah.
Working late though for Friday night.
I am working way late. This guy, he comes in, he's only home on the weekends, so I told him text me whenever you get in, text me and I'll take care of you. So and I've been so busy that I have to do it. So.
Yeah. This ain't nice, this is a pretty nice place.
Thank you. Yeah, make yourself at home.
You gonna cut my hair next?
Well, I could. You're desperate.
Yeah.
Huh?
Side day trip. Want a beer? You want a beer?
No, I'm good.
He's got to drive.
Trust me, I still got to drive home. Otherwise, yes, I would totally take you up on that.
So I bought it before I went to my last job, and I just pulled two out, left the rest in the fridge at the office.
Oh, did you? Well, I was going to say, I got beer in there, too. It's a hazy IPA. It's got grapefruit.
Well, see, while I travel on the road, there's normally a six-pack of beer, and then this last time, I bought a bottle of Jack Daniel's Tennessee Fire, and it's sitting in the duffel bag in the car.
Is that cinnamon?
I bought a
their cinnamon whiskey.
My wife and I got a fire tour. Got to pick a thing, go down there, go to Lynchburg, go through the distillery.
Yeah, there's also a bottle of Pendleton at home. So I'm quite covered in the alcohol area. But normally, yeah, I drink a six-pack in a week. That's a couple beers every night after work, so. But if I wasn't driving, yes, I would totally. So take you up on that.
You want me to run home, come back, so I'm not all high on my pick with off. Take 6 minutes to walk home.
It's up to you. I'll be a little bit.
Yeah,
at least 15 minutes.
I'll walk home and order that.
Three and a half blocks
away,
so we'll do that one.
You got. Well, not that you were probably expecting to walk in, but.
No, and that's. I'm going against my.
Your policy?
Well, yeah, I mean, she can't see, because that's what happens. So if you don't set parameters, mm-hmm. then it's like you can do it anytime I'm in here.
Right. Well, I mean,
like I said, right now it's just so busy that I really do have to leave.
Yeah. Well, I mean, me and you both kind of work this one out because, you know, it works in my schedule and. Because otherwise, I mean, yeah, trust me, if I had a closer job where I was home every night and I got off by a certain time, yeah, great, I'll, you know, come up on a night that you're open late. But,
yeah.
Until that day comes, then. Well, I mean, really? Wow. Talking to a friend of mine that lives out on the East Coast in Connecticut or Massachusetts. I always get the two confused, but one of the two. But he's going to barber school, and. Talking to him tonight, and he's like, well, a lady down the street just opened a barber shop, and I really hope I don't lose any of my walk-ins or anything. And I'm like, well, I said, what do you normally charge? And he's like, 13. I said, well, if, you know, people are loyal to you and they like your work, that you ain't gonna lose them. But he's like, it's the ones I haven't done before. Well, that you can't control. I'm sorry, that's one thing you can't control. But people that like your work and everything, then yeah. He got really excited. He bought himself a new pair of shears and sent me a picture. Oh, yeah, those are nice, bud. He's like, God, I can't wait to use them. Okay.
You mean scissors?
Mm-hmm. Great big suckers, too.
Yeah.
Wednesday, Thursday, and got off today somewhere around right before 4, so maybe 3:30, 3:45, and it started at 7:30, so Summertime's a little different. We work 7 to 7.
Yeah.
Yeah. That makes sense. Those are my 12 hours. Those suck.
Yeah, because it's hot too.
Well, yeah, but my only break all day is 30 minutes for lunch.
Really?
Uh-huh, really. Kid you not. You know, wintertime, right now it's kind of nice out, but as it goes on, we'll need coveralls and everything else, and having to go out and work in the snow, unless it, you know, it's so cold that, like, equipment won't start or something.